It's about to go down. Zombies will never be the same again. Play the damn intro.
A war unlike any you have ever seen. The Great
My dudes, I have a succulent, Jesus Christ, that word is so good, I have a succulent video for you today, but unfortunately the quality is not going to be as good because I'm still ill and it's taken a toll on my voice, so I sound like a robot that's just has AIDS, so it's kind of like terrible, but we'll get through it. But the actual content of the video is outstanding, boys. We are talking about the Great War. We are going to paint the picture of the final battle, the final map of the Aether Zombie storyline. Well, unless Treyarch decide to like do a spin-off storyline, I kind of hope so, because if not, zombies will never be the same, and Chaos storyline's kind of like, it's not gonna... Yeah, let's jump into it. So, how exactly are we gonna go about this? I'm guessing DLC 2 is Nuketown. We're gonna have Ultimus, and doing stuff in Nuketown might have something to do with a transit crew, and then I think the end of Nuketown and the beginning of the Great War is gonna be somewhat similar to the end of Garrod Crovy and Revelations, right? It's gonna... Because it's still... The cycle is broken, right? At the end of Blood of the Dead, we hear that the cycle is broken. History is now different. The future is different. However, I think the events are still gonna mirror each other. They're gonna be very similar. So I'm guessing in the Nuketown map, just like in Garrod Crovy, we're gonna be introduced to Dr. Monty, but now maybe he'll introduce himself to the original crew, the Ultimus crew, who are at Nuketown. And just like this loading screen from the comics suggests, either Takeo, Nikolai, and Dempsey from Blood of the Dead, joined by the like Nuketown and the classified Richtofen, are gonna be the characters for the final map for Great War. Or, like I've also suggested, maybe it could be the transit crew, Ultimus and Primus, three different crews, and maybe you can like jumble up all the characters. It'll be like a huge crossover, huge mashup of 12 characters. That would be large. But honestly, thinking about it more realistically, it probably will just be these four characters that we see right here. Then, just like Revelations, we're gonna go to Dr. Monty's house. We might egg his house, we might break in. Nikolai's gonna block the toilet, it'll flood, it'll be bloody hilarious. Then, the Shadow Man will break out of the summoning key, just like he does. But unlike Revelations, we will not side with Dr. Monty against the Apophicons, Jesus Christ. We will join them. Just think about it. There's, like, Origins to Revelations is the cycle. The cycle's now broken. We need to break the cycle, if not, it just continues. And the Shadow Man wants the same thing as us. We want the same thing as the Shadow Man. We're gonna join his side this time. And I think that event will change the map. That's why the Great War's not just gonna be Revelations remastered. It's gonna be different because the events of it will be different. So, what actually is the map then? Where does it take place? What's it all about? You know, what's going on here? Well, actually, there's like 10,000 hints. So let's look at all the hints, shall we? You know what, Treyarch? You ain't slick, alright? I am slick. I'm buttered up. Well, you're just like a sandpaper. Treyarch, I see what you're doing. So, actually, it is kind of confusing because there's like multiple Great Wars in the zombie storyline. Like, Revelations is a Great War. World War One, which is Origins, was also in real life called the Great War. That's what World War One was called. And then there's also the Medieval Great War, where like the Pablo, which was like the knight and also a World War Two Mexican guy. It literally doesn't make sense, dude. Literally doesn't make sense. And the Eisendrach King from that castle all fought in this Medieval Great War. And that's what I think this map is going to be, right? This Great War in the medieval time against the Apophicons and the Keepers has been hinted at, but we've never really seen much about it, and we've never had a map taken place there. So maybe, even though there's loads of different Great Wars, this will actually be the Great War that we finally play in. In De Eisendrach and other maps, there are actually paintings of the Great War with the Wolf King, the Eisendrak King, a big apothecon in the sky just like in Shadows, and another castle. And all this stuff actually shows the Great War. Not only that, there's also the Eisendrak King, and now we know his servant, the giant, was named Leroy. Wait, his... We call him Leroy, but Treyarch have given him the name, was it Arthur? So maybe the giant from Buried will actually return as a gameplay character, maybe just a or mechanic and a character in the Great War. Imagine that, Leroy, the giant from Buried, is back and he's gonna make those weird ass noises. And no, I'm not gonna copy his noises. Not only that, on Revelations on the Kino stage, there is actually like the Great War depicted, and it has like the Primus characters versus Dr. Monty. It's shown there. There is still so much to go through, but boys, what Treyarch are doing here is honestly amazing. The map, the finale that they are building is just... wow. I hope the map itself can actually be good. Maybe that's too much to ask for, but, you know. But of course, the greatest tease and the greatest look at this medieval setting, this medieval Great War for the finale, is the Revelations ending. It literally shows us the characters standing there. However, it's kind of different because it has the Richtofen, which is now dead, and not the Ultimus Richtofen, but it's still taking a look at the thing. And of course, you can see the mound, right? The like finger, whatever it is, the mound from Origins in the background. And at first, I thought maybe that means the map's going to take place at Origins, well, on the same site. And you might say, oh, a remaster, but it's not. You know, the map could be completely different. I mean, it will be completely different. It just might take place on the same site as Origins, but that not 100% though. For all we know, Treyarch might just say, yeah, that was a bamboozle. There's actually just loads of these mounds, these like 115 rock structures everywhere. You know, the map could take place in ancient China for all we know. Not only that, another massive mystery is that shows the Great War right there, the Primus picture, that's what it's called. However, back in Origins, in Black Ops 2, into like, what, 2013? We got this Primus image, which, if you look, the backgrounds are completely different. The other one was in like this medieval time with that Origins mound in the background. Well, this image looks like it's in like, I don't know, like Greece or something. Once again, there are messages into Eisendrak from the king of the castle, who is now dead, but there are messages from him. But he was in the Great War and he fought alongside the heroes, right? The Primus characters in the Great War. And they told him to build the castle because of the whole paradox time loop thing. So that means the Great War happened in northern France and Austria. So this Great War seemed to happen all across Europe. So the map really could take place anywhere there. But seriously, this map that Treyarch is building, there is so much here. One of my favorite things about Zombies is like the map locations and the character, you know, the vibes, the atmospheres that they create, and this one is just magical. You know, we could have big ass apothecons in the sky, just like we saw in that painting, and just like happens in Shadows of Evil. It's like medieval, it looks kind of dark, and the map looks like it has this kind of blue or purple tint in the background. We're wearing like these medieval things. We have like staff, the original staff, wonder weapons, Dr. Monty versus the Shadow Man. We're helping the Shadow Man, keepers versus the apothecons, with this massive mound in the background. And also, it looks kind of foresty. If you look at the images that I showed you from like the Revelations ending cutscene, the forest that is the menu for Black Ops 3 and 4 Zombies, like it, I don't know, it's, this is so dope, dude. However, I'm pretty sure that Dr. Monty's house, which is in Revelations and in England, I'm pretty sure is going to be part of a map too. So I don't know if the map's going to have like loads of different areas that you can teleport to, kind of like Revelations, but not like Revelations. What if this map is like transit perfected? No. What happens if they go for this semi open world Zombies map for the finale? It's this Great War. You can go to the Origins Mound, you can go to Dr. Monty's house, you can go to Austria, northern France, and it's all the same setting, but it's this large map. Like, oh my god, there's just so much greatness that could happen here. I cannot wait. So Treyarch have an amazing base here. I just hope with the map itself, the storyline, the Easter eggs, and the ending, Treyarch can actually hit it out of the park. And also the marketing, you know, the teasers, the lead up, all of that as well. So guys, that is the video. It kind of sucks. I think the quality would have been much better. It would have been much more interesting if I did not sound like a bloody Dalek from Doctor Who. But anyway, boys, stay spicy, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers, bruv.